Did you know that the main area of data in QuickBooks Online is the chart of accounts? In this episode of QuickBooks Online Crash Course, you will learn how to prepare your chart of accounts in QuickBooks Online. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. An account is simply a record of transactions. In the days before the computer, it was simply a separate piece of paper. In the computer, it's a separate file as part of the QuickBooks software. You need a separate account, or let's say a separate record, for each expense category you have, general income source that you have, and each financial type of account that you have. And of course, you have to have an account for the cash on hand that you use. Here are the example accounts we will use in the course. We will have one record just for video income and a separate record for editing income. It might be helpful to know the difference between how much money came in for doing a video service compared to how much money came in doing an editing service. These are the four example expenses that we will use. They basically represent any example expense, and each category of expense should have its own record or its own account in the chart of accounts. And of course, we have to have one example bank account, one example company credit card account, and a separate account, or let's say a separate record, for the cash on hand that we might receive from customers or pay out to vendors. Now, the accounts that we're going to add to QuickBooks Online are in this list with the extra data that you see here. You have account name, account type, and account detail type. And before you can add an account to the chart of accounts in QuickBooks Online, you have to tell QuickBooks Online all three pieces of information. The account name can be anything you want, as long as you know what it means when you look at the reports that the account appears on. Exactly what you type in as the name is exactly how it will be shown in the reports. Account type determines what type of transaction can be recorded into that account. It also determines which financial statements and reports it will show up on, and it determines the position of the account in the reports. For example, if the account is an expense type of account, it will show up on the profit and loss, and it will show up in the expense section of the profit and loss, and you can only record expenses into that account as you use QuickBooks Online. The detail type is usually not relevant. It sometimes adds functionality to an account, but that's very rare. And we will not need this in our crash course. So let's just use what's on the list here, and one by one we'll record them in the list of accounts in the chart of accounts for QuickBooks Online. We remember from the navigation video that the cogwheel in the top right has the long-term permanent information. So if you're looking for the chart of accounts, you click the cogwheel, go all the way to the left where it says your company, and go down to where it says chart of accounts, and click. Now, if it's the very first time that you're opening up this window, you will see this little picture with this little green button. So you click the little green button, and from this moment forward, this is the window you will see when you click the cogwheel and click Chart of Accounts. You may notice QuickBooks Online has already given you a huge number, or maybe not huge, but a large number of accounts already in the chart of accounts. QuickBooks Online is trying to help you by putting in what it believes is the most commonly needed accounts. So these would be the names of the most commonly used expenses. This might be a general income category. And these other things are for later as you get more advanced into doing the books or doing accounting for other people. Notice it already has an account for uncategorized assets, but we need to put, just like any other company, we need to put our own chart of accounts or add the specific accounts that we need. Remember, it's name, type, and detail type. So how do we add? Well, it's very simple. We go to the top right and click New. Now, the type of the first one is income. And the detail type, I believe, is service fee income. So we just click here and we choose service fee income. And I like to put the name in capital because that will help you distinguish between the ones that you added and the ones that QuickBooks Online gave you. So we have one account, video income, and then we click save and new. And believe me, behind this window, it added that account. Leave these two choices and then add the next one. Now, just for a moment, I want to click save and close so that you can see it added the editing income and the video income. And it put it in the income section of the chart of accounts. So now let's do the four expenses. Delivery, repair, utilities, and transportation. Exactly the same way. And the detail type is other business expense. So step by step, new. This is an expense. This is other business expense. And first it will be, I believe it'll be delivery. Yes, delivery expense. When we click save and new, it'll keep the window open and remember the two choices on the left. So the next name is repair expense. Save and new. The next one would be utilities expense. And then the last one will be transportation expense. Now, after the expenses, I'll click Save and Close just to confirm that the ones in capital letters are the ones that we added ourselves, and we have the correct type and the correct detail type. Now there's only three left: Chase Bank, American Express, and Cash on Hand. We do bank checking for Chase Bank, so click New. It's a bank. The type is checking, cash in Chase Bank. And save and new. And then the next one is a credit, American Express credit card, which is a credit card type of account. So that's easy. When you choose credit card, there is no detail type. Just type American Express. And then save and new. And then, of course, even though the cash on hand is not really a bank account and it's not really checking, it behaves the way a checking account would because you put money into it and you pay money from it. And now if you choose to click Save and Close, you can see that the ones in capital letters are the ones that we made, and you can see they're the correct type and detail type. Now I congratulate you for finishing the setup of your chart of accounts. However, you may well ask, are there other areas of data that we have to manage in order to be able to do the minimum amount of bookkeeping required by the IRS? And the answer is no. If your goal is to do the minimum amount of bookkeeping just to satisfy the tax agencies or anyone who just wants to know what your condition or profit is, then all you have to do is set up the chart of accounts. And for those people who studied accounting, this is what the chart of accounts looks like in a textbook. It's called the general ledger. So if you're only interested in satisfying the IRS and just getting your minimum books done, then this is all you need to set up and prepare. However, your company or the company that you're doing the bookkeeping for might also need what's called peripheral area of data. For example, in addition to the chart of accounts, you might need customers and receivables as a separate area of customer information in order to keep track of the different amounts of money that different customers may owe you at any given moment, and compare that to how much they paid or how much you might owe them in a refund. And that is a separate set of records that is separate from the chart of accounts. You might also owe money to the vendors whom you pay for services that you incur the expenses with, like repair or maintenance or delivery. And if you owe different vendors different amounts of money, you might need a separate area of data with a separate set of records and reports to keep track of that. You also might even have a company that sells merchandise inventory and needs to count the items and keep track of the changes in the quantities and the names and the prices and purchase costs of each item. If the company you're doing the bookkeeping for requires that, then QuickBooks Online would have a separate area of data with a separate set of reports just to manage the inventory. But any of these additional peripheral areas of data would match and be in sync with the main area of data, the general ledger. And in order to know these things, you would have to take a separate little course on each. But the good news is, after this very fast crash course, the additional separate courses for each additional area of data that you may or may not need will be a very easy course, because you will already have a foundation in QuickBooks Online.